Today, I'm going to show you an alternative way of random encounter and apply it to a turn-based combat. This method was used in a game like Etrian Odyssey. Okay, shall we get started? First of all, let's have a recap of what we have done in Random Encounter EP 1. And then I will show you another method, which we will use in current EP, and highlight the difference. In my first episode, I talked about Random Encounter in 3D. This method randomizes number every frame, and if a number is equal to 1, we will show an enemy. This method is used in Pokemon, but we cannot really control the minimum and maximum duration between each encounter. Hence, the next encounter can happen right after the battle has ended. In this EP, I will show you an alternative way that allows users to safely explore before a new enemy has appeared again, and combine it with my turn-based tutorial. The idea is inspired by Etrian Odyssey. When the game starts or after the battle has ended, we will randomize a value to be an encounter threshold, and each step will slowly increase the blue counter. Once the blue counter has reached the threshold, we will enter the battle, and at the same time, we will randomize the new threshold. With this, we can guarantee that a user can safely explore the area before a random encounter happens. And moreover, you can also adapt this method to make some area more dangerous than others. For example, just now in the long grass area, the counter increases faster. So we would have an encounter faster in the tall grass area, like this. But for this tutorial, we will keep it simple and assume that all the area are equally dangerous, like this. Okay, right now it's time to begin our tutorial. As we are going to continue from the turn-based combat tutorial, I have to give you a quick recap on that turn-based tutorial first. So in the turn-based tutorial, the battle will start when I press ZR. And yeah, we will meet a Pidgey, and the battle will start. So this is the part where I trigger an encounter with an enemy, button ZR. And we have a wormhole exit B to indicate if we are in the battle or not. I have made a slight change before starting this tutorial, which is I only allow the person to move when we are not in the battle by adding this program. So what will happen is I check if I'm in the battle or not. If I'm not in the battle, this output will be equal to 1, and I can get the left stick input correctly into the person nodon. But if I'm in a battle, this not nodon will give 0, and 0 times whatever gives 0, so the output here will be 0 and we cannot move the person nodon. So before we are going to add a random encounter, let me fix this first. So right now, I start an encounter when ZR button is pressed, but this is not ideal, right? I want to start when I have got a signal from our random encounter program. So I'm going to remove this. Next, I'm going to add a wormhole. Go to the settings. Whenever an encounter happens, I will send a signal to a wormhole exit. And yeah, I will use this to start a battle here. Okay, now it's time to add a random encounter to this game. So the first question we have to ask ourselves is that when can we have a random encounter? So we can have a random encounter with these three conditions. First, we are walking on the grass area. Second, we are not in a battle. Third, we are moving a stick. To detect if we are walking in the grass area, we can add a touch sensor to check if a person is walking on it or not. Then go to the settings. Check for a person. Output timing is while touched. Proceed. Then I'm going to add and nodon first because we need a few conditions here. And let's connect the first condition into this and nodon. The next condition is that we are moving the stick. So we can add a stick movement left, up, down. We can go to the settings and then change this to any direction of the response. Proceed. Then send this into AND. We still need more conditions, so let me copy this AND nodon first. The next condition is that we are not in the battle. So it is going to be wormhole exit B followed by not. So now we can have the random encounter only if a person is touching this area, the left stick is moving and we are not in the battle. And when this happens, we have to increase the counter. We will use this counter to compare if it has been greater than the encounter threshold or not. Okay, so right now when we are walking in the grass area, the counter will keep increasing. But when should we have an encounter? That is when the value is greater than the random threshold, right? So yeah, I need to find a way to get the random threshold first. And I can obtain that from the random nodon. Go to the settings. Update timing is only on change from 0 because we only need to randomize one time per encounter. Output range, let's set to 1000. So now the random value can be from 1, 2, 3 until 1000. But I want an encounter to happen only from 4 to 6 seconds after the previous encounter. We cannot use the random nodon's output directly because let's say if we get the value 1 here, it means that the encounter will start after just 1 frame only. We want the encounter to happen only after 4 seconds, so the number of frames we need here is 240 because there are 60 frames per second and we need 4 seconds. And because the max duration that we want here is 6 seconds, so we need to set the max value to be 360, which is from 6 times 60. Here I'm going to add a map. Connect the random nodon into map and go to the map settings. Input range is from 0 to 1000. Output range is from 240 to 360. Okay, close it. And now we will have a random encounter when the counter is greater than this random value. So here I'm going to add greater than. And when this happens, we will trigger an encounter by sending the value to wormhole exit E. Okay. When this happens, we have to reset the counter and also random a new value. Another thing to note is that when the game starts, this value is 0, so we also need to random this value on game start too. So when the game starts, we will random a value here. Yeah, let's have an overview of what's going on here. So we have this counter that starts like how long we have walked in the grass. And we have this random threshold. Once the duration has passed the random threshold, we will trigger a random encounter as well as reset the duration here and random a new value. Okay, let's have a demo. So right now I have only implemented the encounter in this grass area. So yeah, after I have walked in this area for a while, I will encounter an enemy. And yeah, right now I don't have any problem of encountering a PG right after the battle has ended. Okay, and yeah, that's it for adding the random encounter. But let's do some final touch here. You may notice that when the new battle starts, the HP of PGs is 0. Okay, we are going to fix that. So to fix this, when an encounter starts, we also have to reset PG's counter. So here I'm going to add a wormhole exit E. And I'm going to use this to reset a PG counter. Okay, let's try again. Yeah, so in our second battle, you see that the PG's HP is max. Yay! And as I mentioned in the introduction, you can further improve this method by like, for example, in some area, you may increase the counter faster. Okay, that's it for most episodes of Random Encounters. I hope you have fun, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Of course, there are more than two ways of doing Random Encounter, so feel free to share yours in the comments. And yeah, that's it. Bye bye, and see you next time.